Well, last time I was here, we talked about the Korn Balance model of family leisure functioning. So I want to talk about that a little bit more again today. Last time, and this is the first slide, I believe, but families need both structure and stability, kind of cohesion, kind of these things that they can rely on. But they also at the same time need challenge, change, novelty, things to help them to change throughout time and you know, have interesting, exciting things to work for. So Dr. Raymond Zabriskie down at BYU, and I'm going through this really fast because it's a review, but Dr. Raymond Zabriskie down at BYU created the Korn Balance model of family leisure functioning. And basically, they put these two ideas together and found that they need both these predictable core activities and the changing balance activities. Mm-hmm. So last time we talked about the
balance,
balance,
is that what you call them?
What they're called.
Which were all of our adventures. It's our family adventures at Lake Powell.
Yeah, these kind of things that are new and exciting and adventures and fun, and that you need those, and sometimes they're hard work, but that it's definitely worth it. But today we're going to talk about core. So this is my second slide, so you can kind of see that. But core activities are more of the common, everyday, low cost, often home-based, relatively accessible. And you can see through this little model, this lovely little model, that these core activities lead to stability, family structure, and actually family cohesion. So families who are able to establish these kind of core activities and patterns together have this kind of cohesion, which basically means being together, being tight-knit, having family unity, family identity. And for kids, actually makes a big deal because it creates a sense of safety.
And belonging, I think.
Of belonging, of reliability, of this is who we are and I'm safe and I have these activities with the family.
Is it also kind of like having a tribe or even, you know, gangs? You know, isn't that why a lot of kids get involved in gangs? Because they need that.
They need,
that cohesion.
They need cohesion, they need identity, they need belonging, to belong somewhere. And how much better is it for them to have that belonging with family than with maybe peers and other kind of not so wholesome groups, or even peers that are good? It's just not quite the same.
Right.
So some example of core activities are easy home-based things.
Right.
One of the biggest ones that we talk about, and lots of research says that it's really, really important, is meals, family meals. It's one of the leading predictors of strong families, is whether you have dinner together.
Yeah, in fact,
really
they
simple,
talked the food nanny talked about that on Kim's show yesterday. It was really good.
Yeah, it's really, really important. I think we have a couple pictures. And these are some examples of core activities. This is Brielle, my niece. And
that's my first granddaughter.
Her first granddaughter. I love, if you look at this cake, you can see how involved Brielle was in the making of the cake, because there's a baby stroller and an elephant in water and lots of really crazy things. So it's such a great chance.
We decorate it together.
This is one of the great things, is to take advantage of these random opportunities and just let kids be involved, which actually makes it a lot more difficult, let's be honest, but is actually really good for them. Here's an example of the mom and the baby in the garden working together. Also probably more difficult for the mom than if she was just on her own, but what a great opportunity for them to be together. And working together is actually a big thing, because it not only gives you that cohesion, reliability, but it helps to teach your kids how to work.
I have a quick question for you.
Sure.
I'm pretty anal retentive about, you know, if I'm baking a cake and want the kids to, you know, do it the way I want it, is it really important to make sure that they're involved in the artistic aspect of it?
Well, no, and I was actually reading a book recently, and she was talking about how she was involved in making the cake, and she felt like the things that she was doing was so important. But as she looked back as an adult, she realized, oh, mom measured the flour and I dumped it in, you know, like really small things. Okay. So if there's specific things, if you're making a cake for a wedding, you're not going to let, you know, baby decorate it. And that's fine, as long as they feel like they're a part of it, that they're a part of that creative process.
And it depends on the child. Some of them are going to be satisfied with pouring in the flour. Others, like Brielle that you just saw on that slide, she's going to be very specific about how she wants to decorate it and all of that. And we're like getting real short on time, so.
Oh, so we want to come up with some examples of core activities. So we're going to go through some. I'll throw out a couple so you kind of get an idea. Family dinners, and Danny, if you could write for us, be our lovely scribe.
He's writing.
She's writing. Vanessa, nice. Family dinner is a really good one. Another good one. Yeah, right. So write all these down so we can kind of think of all these activities, because they're so easy that it makes it hard, if that makes sense. It's hard to.
They did show the slide of dad with Brielle.
Oh, and another one, you see the little girl and the dad playing, or the grandpa playing the piano. Oh, you're fine. No, that's another, just these spontaneous opportunities there to just be together, play together, practice together, have fun together. So another one, a really good one, is reading to kids. Like bedtime stories, that's a really, really good one. I have more, but do you guys have any?
How about like working
anything.
Together?
Yard work,
like the yard work,
like
yes.
That.
Work,
yeah.
That's a big one. Yard work, housework, helping them learn how to actually clean a bathroom. It seems like work, but it's actually time that you can spend together and be
and everybody's
together.
Everybody's different what they do for a living. There's a joke around here that my kids are on the show almost as much as I am. So that's what I have access to, so I bring my kids here and they love it and they got
that's,
memories forever.
That's
so that's
a
one
great
I use.
Idea.
So on TV.
That's a good one.
Yeah. Work. Well, involve them in your work.
Involve them in your activity.
Yeah.
Well, I heard once that you should just involve your kids in whatever your passion is. Mm. And so you guys were in plays and all kinds of things like that when you were little.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you just involve them in everything. What about
you
even
know,
just driving places, driving places?
That's true.
That can
nowadays,
be valuable
especially
time.
With televisions and all these lovely things that we have to keep the kids occupied, we don't spend time together. So a really important thing is to sometimes turn off the television and interact.
Okay.
Play
it.
Games together.
That's
I'm
going
to add in a big one for my family real quick at the end here. Because we just
wrestle time.
That's perfect.
We're not talking
That's
about
great.
You and your husband.
We just
We're talking
spend
about you
15
and the
minutes
kids.
And we throw each other around the house. It's the funnest thing.
Love it. Love it. Going on walks, maybe if you're just.
We're out of time.
Adult. Yay!
We're out of time. Congratulations.
So keep thinking of ideas.
Those are great.
Thank you.
Thank you.